Welcome to the Pickballed. I'm Matt Taylor alongside Danny Sib. Today's Monday, which means we have a Monday Night Football matchup between two teams here in the AFC East as the New York Jets take on the New England Patriots. Now, obviously, we're seeing a quarterback matchup that many people leading into the season wouldn't expect in this one as Joe Flacco takes the ball here for the Jets, taking on against Cam Newton and this Patriots team. So get ready, unlock your money, get ready for picks, plays, and score projections coming your way right now. This is the Pickballed.
Welcome to the Pick Vault, taking sports gambling to the next level. No more winging it. It's time to get paid. We're a sports gambling consultation firm. We use sports, news, sports data, stats, and analytics, and we help you unlock your money. Get ready to start winning. This is the Pick Vault, and here's Matt Taylor and Danny Sib.
It's the Pick Vault. Gonna sit you down and listen to this real talk. Ain't no first or second option, this the default. Turning picks into these dollars, gonna let them fall. Raining down these daily winnings like an aerosol. Analytics calculated just to win it all. Problems when it comes to choosing, we got all them solved. Got the picks that need and fixed, and you know who to call. Cause this the Pick Vault.
And he is right, that's JLive Official. Go check him out on Apple Music, Spotify, or right here on Instagram at JLive Official. And again, Danny, welcome back to the studio. It is Monday, and like I said, Monday Night Football as the 0-8 New York Jets take on the 2-5 Patriots. So obviously both these teams have underperformed by every margin. The Jets have kind of blown up this organization, and there's obviously conversations about what their future looks like, especially as you're talking about what's going on here, because Joe Flacco, who they're going out and they get in the offseason to back up Sam Darnold, in my opinion, great decision by this Jets organization to get someone like a Flacco who has made a Super Bowl run, who has made obviously consistent playoff appearances when he was with the Ravens, and all of a sudden a young guy like Sam Darnold could be really impacted by bringing on somebody, a veteran like a Joe Flacco. But obviously that wasn't what happened, right? So far this season, Sam Darnold has underperformed, in my opinion, at every single level. This team has the talent to get wins in this league, but being 0-8 at this point in the season, what does this Jets team need to do moving forward? Now, obviously, you're being facetious here, and this conversation is obviously a theoretical one because there's really no turning around this year. So if you're in the Jets organization, what are you doing today, and what are you doing moving forward? Now, they go out in the last week and the week before that and make some moves, and they get rid of Le'Veon Bell, who may have been a little bit of again, for a lack of better words, a cancer for this organization, and you remove it. So what do you do moving forward, and what kind of statement does it make here, seeing Flacco on the field today in a situation where the team is 0-8? Is it time to move on from Sam Darnold? Is it time to move on from a guy that obviously hasn't been what you thought he was?
Well, I don't know, really. There's a lot of people out there, Matt, obviously, that thought Sam Darnold was the answer. But again, maybe that's a little bit of that New York mentality. New quarterback, USC, big shot comes in and obviously just doesn't have it. But again, it's the Jets organization. And here on out, Matt, I'll be honest with you. I know it's a bad statement, and I know it's one thing that teams don't look to do. But I think the best thing here for the Jets to do is lose. I think you got to tank the rest of the season. But honestly, they don't even try to tank. It kind of just happens naturally because of the product they do put on the field. So I think the best thing for the Jets, you got to get that number one pick and get Trevor Lawrence. I think that's your best answer.
So you're saying it's time to get rid of Darnold now?
I mean, I think it's time. I would say, and I know this is something that you like to touch on, do you get rid of Sam Darnold now? And now I'll bring up the question to you. Is there more value getting rid of Darnold now and making that decision than if you waited, I'd say, to the end of the season? Is there really any difference here?
There absolutely is a difference, again, and the reason being, and I don't know, understand anyone that could disagree with this point, the reason being there's teams like the Cowboys that need a quarterback today. They're not going to need a quarterback in the offseason, right? The Cowboys won't need a starting quarterback next season because they're going to re-sign Dak to a longer-term deal. At some point in time, that deal will get done, and we're seeing how impactful Dak was. And I obviously was wrong about Dak Prescott. I'll be the first one to say it. Yeah. He made a significant difference in that organization, not only last year, but obviously starting out this season. Totally different team, now than it looked when they had Dak on the roster. The one thing that I'll note, You have an opportunity right now. If you're Jerry Jones, you have an opportunity right now to go out and get a guy like a Sam Darnold, like a Ryan Fitzpatrick. And we've been saying it all along. The reason I believe there's more value in getting him now is because no one's going to need him next season.
Right.
No one's looking at Sam Darnold and saying, oh my God, this is a diamond in the rough that could do great for our organization. No, let's be honest about this. Everyone wants to blame everyone else. And I'm kind of at the point where I'm no longer going to blame the coaching staff. I'm no longer going to blame this organization, really. At some point in time, Sam Darnold's got to put his big boy pants on and he's got to accept the fact that he's got to make some changes to his ball game.
I agree.
He's not prepared. And I think one of the things that we have to talk about is he had weapons. Everyone's like, oh, it's the Jets organization. Hold on a second. He had Le'Veon Bell. He had Robbie Anderson. And there's been consistent whether it comes down to he didn't have all the weapons in the world. No. And I'm not blind to it. And I'm not going to sit here and pretend to be blind to it.
Absolutely not.
But we have to talk about the fact that Sam Darnold has been extraordinarily a letdown for this organization since the moment he came in. And he's another guy that came in with so much hype. And as much as I agree with you, it's time to go out and get rid of him. I do believe that's the first step. But Flacco's not terrible. I'm going to say this tonight. I think tonight we're going to see Flacco play competitive football. I don't know if he's going to win the game tonight. I don't think so. But he'll play competitive football. And that's a question you have to have with the organization.
Right.
Right? Is it time to go draft the Trevor Lawrence? Or you got to build with what you have? Because at some point in time, you got to build with what you have due to the fact that you go out there and you get Sam Darnold.
Right.
And you already sold to the New York fans for years that this is our savior. This is our guy. He's going to come in and change this organization. And it's been a failure.
Yeah,
100%.
And I guess one of the biggest questions really is can he be a savior? Which I kind of side with you. If Jerry Jones, I mean, we're using the Cowboys as an example, probably the best example I'd say in this case. If they were to go get Sam Darnold, right? You could find out your season, for the most part, is most likely shot with the whole situation. I mean, again, they are in the NFC East. Anything can happen. But wouldn't you want to know if Sam Darnold can actually have some potential? Or do you just bank on him next season? Like, you can't rely on him to be a, I don't even want to say starter, but you're just going to take him next season. I would like a tryout before I, you know,
This is not about a tryout at all. This is not about a tryout. What I'm telling you right now is that with the weapons that the Dallas Cowboys have today, if you get a guy like Sam Darnold who's at least half decent, I mean, we're dealing with right now in Dallas. The quarterback position has been an utter disaster.
Yep.
And it's no one's fault. There just was injury and then another injury. And now we're at a third string. And again, there's not many teams in this league that have a third string quarterback that can play at a high level football.
Yep.
All of a sudden, you're putting your third string quarterback in there against some of the better teams in the NFL.
Right,
you're not going to succeed.
Yeah, against the Steelers defense. I mean, he fared decent.
This has nothing to do with a tryout whatsoever, in my opinion. I'm not throwing away your point.
What I will say is,
you go out and get Sam Darnold, who's a decent quarterback, a starting quarterback, a first-string quarterback right now at least.
Right. Well, I just want to know if he could do it long-term. That's kind of what I mean by
that. I don't care about long-term. That's what I'm telling you. Stop looking long-term. I'm telling you right now the answer in Dallas is to get Sam Darnold. Right now the answer in Dallas is go get Ryan Fitzpatrick. You have a team. You're in a shitty division, to be honest. Let's just be frank. You're in the worst division in the history of the NFL, and guess what? You are not out of it. There's 8 weeks remaining in this season.
If
you go get Sam Darnold, you go get Fitzpatrick, and you string together four wins, that's all he has to do.
Mm-hmm.
And they're in the playoffs.
Yeah, absolutely.
String together four, go 4-4, and you're in the playoffs in that division,
which is crazy. Yeah, which is crazy. I have a big win by the Giants yesterday, not to get sidetracked, but again, in that NFC East division, it's wide open. Absolutely wide open.
Well, that makes the point even
clearer. I agree with you.
So if I'm Jerry Jones, I'm going out and making some sort of move. And we're getting to a point where if you don't do it, you're letting the whole organization down.
Yeah, like, what are you waiting for?
Unless he's got
something up his sleeve, Matt. You never know. He might.
What could he possibly have up his sleeve?
I don't know. I'm just saying, like, there's some reason, there's something holding him back or something from going to get somebody. Because I don't know.
I don't think there's anything holding him back. I just think that shows how much little faith he has in Sam Darnold. How much little faith.
And again,
take another step. I don't think, as much as we're talking about the AFC East here, flipping it over to the Jets side, you're in a division where a team like the Dolphins, who have a backup quarterback in Ryan Fitzpatrick, them not getting rid of Fitzpatrick after how well he played early on this season and how well we've seen him be able to adapt to different organizations, be able to adapt, Them not letting him go says a lot about what they think about Tua. As much as Tua's been overperforming, in my opinion, the past few weeks,
100%.
Once we get the tape on Tua in the NFL and once we see him with this Dolphins team, I'm going to put a question mark. I'm not ready to get all in on Tua.
I agree with you. I'm not all in either. I mean, talking about Tua yesterday and Kyler, I was always about there's never going to be a comparison between. I think Kyler Murray is a superb player, quarterback, but Tua, I don't want to say, like you said, he overperformed. Can he do that at a consistent basis? We'll find out, but I agree with you. I'm not all in on Tua yet.
What I'm telling you is, and we're talking about the NFC East, and we're talking about all the things that could go on in the NFL, and frankly, we don't know what's going to go on. All I'm saying is the fact that this Dolphins team does not let Fitzpatrick go, and don't fool yourself. Jerry Jones is not an idiot. He knows that there's well enough time in this season, and there's well enough talent and enough talent on this team that they have now that if they did make a move, they had a legitimate chance, and they do have a legitimate chance, even if they make a move now.
Yeah.
At a playoff run, and frankly, again, we've seen it year in and year out. You don't know what could happen, especially when you have a guy in your on your roster like a Zeke. When you have a guy on your roster like the...
So you got CeeDee Lamb, Amari Cooper. I mean, you got everybody, really.
So, in my opinion, I think a move will be made at some point in time, and I don't understand any Jets fan or anybody out there that says you're not going to get... Guess what? If you get Trevor Lawrence... Next season, if you're a Jets fan, you guys draft Trevor Lawrence and you have Sam Darnold, what makes you believe someone's going to want him next season if they don't want him now when a team is in a dire need for a quarterback? A dire need for a quarterback. You're never going to see a team that needs a quarterback more than the Dallas Cowboys need a quarterback right now. You will never see it at any point in the NFL. We've never seen the history of the NFL. There's never been more of a need to complete an organization than right now in Dallas.
Right.
And guess what? The fact that Sam Darnold hasn't been really in the conversation to be picked up there. That's the problem. Yeah. And Jets fans that are blind to that and think all of a sudden in the offseason, all of a sudden people are going to be calling about Sam Darnold. You're not only bullshitting everyone else, you're bullshitting yourself. And that's where...
New York mentality, Matt.
Forget the New York mentality. It's just ignorant, in my opinion. And again, I'm not shitting on anybody, but... It's ignorant to believe that you're going to get more for Sam Darnold next season than you would right now when there's a team like the Cowboys that absolutely, utterly, without question, need a quarterback to complete their roster today. Yeah,
they're the epitome of like working with what you got. Like they are doing anything possible. They're Zeke's running wildcat. I mean, they'll do anything possible. I guess honestly, that's a good point. I never really thought about that.
So we'll see what happens, with Sam Darnold. But the story has to be that Joe Flacco's getting the ball tonight.
Yeah, and hey, you never know, man. Like you said, Matt, he has that Super Bowl caliber. He's been there. He knows what he's doing. And, I mean, against, I know we've been riding the Jets, but, I mean, this game is interesting in itself. On a primetime night, you would think this Jets-Patriots duel would have been an absolute, no one really cares about it, but you got a Patriots team, Matt, that is 0-4 in their last four games, looking for that fifth loss in a row, which has never, ever happened under Bill Belichick. Will that happen today?
No. No. I'm laughing because I think this whole conversation today, and that's why I'm not necessarily, again, I'll be completely transparent with Pickball Nation. This game is not even fun to talk about.
No, I'm
talking about an uncompetitive game, and this will be a blowout tonight. I don't care what the Pickball projection is saying. All I'm telling you is right now, Bill Belichick has a lot to prove.
Yeah, definitely.
And I'm even going to take this a step further. Tom Brady last night looked like absolute crap. And he got shit on social media. People have been attacking him left and right. And guess what? If Bill Belichick gets a win tonight in a resounding form and everything looks great and everything kind of clicks and all of a sudden this team is 3-5. I understand they're not in a good position. I do not envy where they are. But let's really start thinking about this. Next week, you're probably going to get Edelman back healthy. Okay? First step. You come off a win tonight against a really, really, really bad worst team in the history of the NFL. I'm going to go there. The worst team in the history of the
NFL. Totally
fair. And they surpassed the Browns. This organization needs to make a move not only at the quarterback position, at the coaching position, at the general manager's position. This organization, again, I think you're 10 years away from recovering from the moves that they've made over the past. You're 10 years away, which is sad to say.
That is horrible to say, especially for New York.
Because even if you go out and get Trevor Lawrence, they're saying Trevor Lawrence might not want you in the Jets. And we've seen it happen before with 100%. Eli Manning. We've seen it happen before across the board. We've seen it consistently happen multiple times. And all I'm saying is, if I'm Trevor Lawrence and I start looking around on that team, and I see that we don't have an offensive line. I see that we have a question mark at the coaching position. I see that we just gave away our star running back. I see that we gave away our number one receiver. I'm starting to question if this is the place that I want to spend the beginning years of my career. And we've seen it before, where a quarterback is touted as the next coming of whatever you want.
Talent, yeah, GOAT status.
And then what happens is they come into a situation and they get injured, or they get play very poorly because there's no offensive line or there's no situation and no opportunity at success. And that is what I fear with Trevor Lawrence and this Jets team. But again, talking about tonight and talking about this Patriots team, you improved to 3-5 today. You have a very interesting stretch of games. Next week against the Ravens. Now, I understand that's a tough game, but heading into before this four-game stretch of how bad they've played, the four-game stretch again, and I'm not giving any excuses, but Cam Newton had COVID, okay? Cam Newton came back and was out 2 weeks and then came back, and he's coming back. He's probably not 100% healthy. Let's be honest here. He comes back. He's not 100% healthy. He's playing the quarterback position in a new system in his first year with a new coach, and again, he's talked about how it is calculus. I'm just telling you, I wouldn't count this Patriots team out. I wouldn't count Bill Belichick out. I wouldn't count Cam Newton out. And I'll be honest with you, the fact of the matter is, I think they can win next week against the Ravens.
That's exactly what I was about to say. I didn't want to cut you off. This is a Ravens team, and they're in a situation where without their defense playing the way they're playing, they're not in any game. They have no form of offense, and I know you're going to say, well, the Patriots don't really either, but if anything, you're looking at Lamar Jackson, Cam Newton. I don't want to say they're similar in quarterback types, but right now, you got two quarterbacks that the big question mark is, can they throw the football? So it's going to come down to a ground game, obviously. And like you said, I think the Ravens are in a situation that they easily could lose next week the way their offense has been playing. I agree with you.
I'm telling you right now, we have seen Cam Newton do things this season that he hasn't done in 4 years. And that's just being I was a Panthers fan. I've seen him in the Super Bowl. I've seen him at his best, and I've seen him at his worst. I've seen him injured. I've seen him healthy. I'm just telling you right now, I'm not counting this Patriots team out, and I believe if you are, you have not watched football for the past 20 years.
I agree with you.
Because you know what? Let's just be frank about it. Tom Brady is playing some of the best football of his life, barring, again, forget yesterday for a minute, playing some of the best football of his life. He has more weapons today than at any point in his career. Okay. More weapons than at any point in his career.
Over his career with the Patriots, he has more weapons, like you said, combined for the most part.
And look at their record. They have 3 losses on this year. He has more talent. So all of a sudden we say, who really is, again, on the flip of it, you have a Patriots team that has never been 2-5 under Bill Belichick. And all of a sudden, the conversation I believe we should be having right now is not who's better, Brady or Belichick. That's been the conversation for the past 20 years. Who's the mastermind of this organization? Who's the reason for their success? And I believe this season is proving right now that it's not Brady. And it's proving that it's not Belichick. It's proving what we've known all along. And that is, together, Brady and Belichick is the system.
I agree. Why can't anyone come together, Matt? I agree with you. Everything's got to be such a divide. And to be honest with you, everyone's pinning things on Belichick. I mean, like you said, if anyone's watched football in the past 20 years and all the unfortunate circumstances that we have to go through, Matt, today on their roster, they have 13 guys not playing, and that's not including the 6 defensive guys that opted out of the season before the season even started. So if anything, with what Belichick has been dealt, like you said, maybe he's dealing with it as best he really can. He has no choice.
I'm telling you, and I'm gonna go on record here. I'm telling you right now, this Patriots team is gonna have a legitimate chance in the last 3 games of the season. I'm not gonna put them in the playoff picture yet, but I'm gonna tell you right now, heading into the final 3 games of the season, they will be relevant. I'm not gonna say they're guaranteed to be able to play for something, but right now you're 2-5. What leads you to believe that they can't? Let's even forget the Ravens.
Man, I'll be honest with you.
Let's forget the Ravens for a second. They play the Texans, who I think they're clearly better than right now.
Yeah.
They play the Cardinals, who I think they easily can win, especially after we saw what was able to happen last night with a young quarterback. You play the Chargers, who again,
young quarterback,
Bill Belichick, defensive mind. I probably am putting my hand in it. All of a sudden, you got a game against the Rams, which could be very meaningful. If this team goes 4-0 in the next weeks and you go Jets, Ravens, Texans, Cardinals, 4-0.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, you're 6-5 in a game against the Rams. could go either way. Even at a loss, you're 6-6 heading to a game against who? The Dolphins, who is going to be up there in the top of their division, and then you cap off and you play the freaking Bills, and then you finish the season playing the Jets one more time just to get one more win under your belt.
And Matt, I actually love that, because the one thing I didn't want to cut you off, but prior to last week, if anyone remembers that Bills game, they probably should have won that one. So like you're saying, it's almost gearing up for that Bills game at the end of the season. That's the game that's going to mean something. That's the game that Cam Newton isn't going to fumble the ball on the 20-yard line going into the game. That could be the game that, like you said, Patriots prove themselves. So I think it'll be interesting. Obviously, tonight should be an absolute, I don't want to say a shit show, but I agree with you. I think the Patriots should and will roll tonight, honestly.
And what I will say is there has been conversations of extending the playoff.
So it helps their case even more.
Could you imagine if after all the hatred that's gone on between New England and Roger Goodell, and all the hatred and all the talk of the battle between the Patriots and the NFL, all I'm going to say is, could you imagine if they expand the playoff and the extra team that gets in is the Patriots? I'm not saying that's going to happen. Telling you they're going to be relevant going down the stretch. Don't count them out. And if you are counting them out, again, I don't believe you've been knowledgeable about the past 20 years. And I think you should go refresh yourself and talk about some of the teams that Bill Belichick was able to coach up to turn around the season. And I'm not saying anything right now, but Doesn't this kind of remind you, I'm not going to say it identical, remind you of a team that ended up beating the Patriots in a Super Bowl?
Are you talking about my Giants, Matt? Is that what you're talking about? Continue. Again, I need to hear this.
This team has the pieces, in my opinion, to get hot at the right time, especially on the defensive side of the football. And if Cam Newton is healthy, and if Cam Newton can be the dual threat that we saw him do against the Seahawks, if he could play the way he played against the Seahawks, I'm not saying he can. It's still a question mark. But if he could do what he did against Russell Wilson and that Seahawks defense on a primetime game throughout a consistency of 3, 4, 5, 6 consecutive weeks.
Just protect the ball.
All I'm going to say is this team could get scary and hot at the right time. And we know, and you know specifically as a Giants fan, that sometimes it's not about being the best team on the field. It's about being the hottest team on the field.
Absolutely.
And I'm telling you right now, don't count this Patriots team out. And you got to remember, they finished their season against the Jets. One more time.
Right.
The Jets, the worst team in the history of the NFL. The worst organization in the history of the NFL. And I believe today starts their track to the playoffs. And I believe it goes through the Jets one more time to get to the playoffs.
Right.
So I'm just saying, symbolically speaking, this game obviously is do or die. You lose this, you're done. You lose this, Cam, gone.
Oh, if Cam loses, and I was going to say, especially with, I mean, media in general today, they will troll Cam Newton. I will feel bad. It's not going to happen. Like we said, there's no shot the Jets win this game. But this game means so much, I want to say, for Cam Newton, because of what the internet will do to him if he loses to the Jets. This is the last thing he needs. Like you said, he needs that ego boost. We need to see Super Cam today, Matt. Have to see it. We say it every week. He always is doing this. Has to happen today.
So one of the storylines of this season so far has been Cam Newton, has been the reemergence of the fact that, again, he has the talent to be great. And there was a three-week period, you'll remember it, a three-week period. After the first 3 weeks of the season, even after the loss to the Seahawks, that everyone was saying, oh my gosh, look what freaking Belichick did. He has resurrected Super Cam. He has resurrected this organization, and everything's going to come together.
Right. And then, Matt, not to cut you off, but 276 passing yards average with any rush for 4 touchdowns in those 3 weeks. But continue.
No, agreed. And one thing that I have to say is, he has 2 touchdown passes and 7 picks on this season. He's been playing like crap the past 3 weeks.
Right, and that all came from these past 3 weeks.
I agree. That's all coming from when he's not 100% at his best, not 100% healthy. And I believe now, second half of the season, he's had his rest. He's already had COVID-19. There's nothing to worry about there. And you're talking about a guy that I believe has the opportunity to get hot at the right time. And again, I'm not counting them out. You can. I'm not ready to do that quite yet.
No, I'm not going to count them out. Not yet.
So today, Dan, obviously, again, you're going up against the Jets. So let's hear the pick vault projection. Patriots, Jets, let's hear it.
Here we go. We got Patriots taking this one, obviously, 28-13, setting that total at 41, which does put it under. And a little nugget for everyone out there, the last 5 out of 6 games the Jets have played, the under has hit. And that actually comes from them only averaging 10 points or less for those last five games. So don't look for anything from the Jets side today. And we do have the Patriots covering that 10 spread, Matt.
And I'm going to be on the same page. I don't believe the Jets score more than 14 points today. I think you're talking about a 13-point outing for the. Maybe they get one touchdown and two field goals in this one. I think you're talking about a 13-point, especially with the defense. And especially, like I said, Bill Belichick has had time to coach up this defense. And he knows if their defense is at their best, they're going to be in every ball game. And they have been. Even the games they've lost by one possession. They lost to the Seahawks on the goal line. They lost to the Bills last week on a fumble. Pretty much going in.
Yeah.
So you flip those two games around, and this team is in a much different scenario.
Absolutely.
And that's all I'm telling you. You're counting them out based on their record, but don't count them out because they've been in every single game, and there's one play that can go either way.
Absolutely.
And I think for the past 3 weeks, we've seen one play go the wrong way for them, and I think at some point
they're due.
It's coming back the other way, and I'm talking about this Patriots team moving forward doing big things. I believe you're going to see an explosion from Super Cam tonight. Yeah. I am putting that on record. I am a Panthers fan. I have watched Cam Newton throughout his career. I've seen him at his worst. Like I said, I've seen him at his best. And I believe he's poised against this Jets defense.
Absolutely.
To do big things. I'm talking about 3-4 touchdown passes. Again, I'm 3-for-3 so far. I'm 3-for-3 so far calling a 4-touchdown pass game. I'm not going to do it today. I think 3 touchdown passes for Cam Newton. He surpasses what he's done all season. Ooh, so far.
He's going to light it up today.
And I think he rushes for a touchdown as well, at least one. I believe we're talking about 3 passing touchdowns and 1 rushing touchdown for Cam Newton. And you will see Super Cam be Super Cam tonight.
I can't wait for that, Matt. I'm honestly all with you. I know we usually throw player props out there, but I think the only player prop that's actually worth it tonight, because I'm not going to rely on anyone on the Jets to regardless score, but who knows how they're going to get in the end zone, if they even do. So I think, like you're saying, Cam Newton to score is absolutely the play. There's no other way to put it. He's the one to score. They have injuries everywhere else. You know, you ride and die off of Cam, and today the Patriots ride, baby.
Absolutely. So, again, I believe, one more time, Dan, let's hear that score projection one more time. Finally, let's hear it.
We got Patriots 28 to the Jets 13, obviously covering that 10 spread, and the under is the pick vault play as well, and there's the projection for
you,
Matt.
So, the pick vault play is New England Patriots minus 10, Cam Newton to score a touchdown, and the under 41. Right?
Yep, absolutely.
And again, this has been the Pick Vault. And again, all these picks, all these plays, and all these score projections are brought to you by the Artificial Intelligence Computer Simulations that is the Pick Vault. And again, we appreciate your time. We appreciate you guys listening. And we are
OUT out.
You've been listening to the Pick Vault, America's premier sports gambling consultation firm. Matt Taylor and Danny Siv are ready to make you a winner and unlock your money. Make sure to hit the website at www.thepickvault.com. Find the app and subscribe to receive exclusive member content, including our picks, live updates, and sports news. Follow on Twitter and Instagram at ThePickVault, taking sports gambling to the next level. Till next time, this is The Pick Vault, signing off.
This The Pick Vault, gonna sit you down and listen to this real talk. Ain't no first or second option, this the default. Turning picks into these dollars, gonna let them fall. Raining down these daily winnings like an aerosol. Analytics calculated just to win it all. Problems when it comes to choosing, we got all them solved. Got the picks that needin' fixed, and you know who to call. Cause this the Pick Vault.